This video is about the three C's of the wholesaling real estate business. Stay tuned. Hey, my friend, this is Ola coming to you live from my Empire Pro Studios. On this episode, in this edition, we'll dive into the three of the seven core principles to building a real estate wholesaling business with the universal forces of the law of attraction. I want to talk about the three C's, okay? I have another video on this channel where I talk about the whole seven as a complete, but I'm going to dive a little bit deeper into the three C's. But as usual, this was inspired because of a question that came in, and I wanted to, you know, cover that in details here. So hopefully you will enjoy this video. The question goes, hi Ola, I'm a new investor and I'm particularly starting with wholesaling pre-foreclosures. That's a good one. I started with that as well too, okay? And I think, in my opinion, it's probably some of the best leads that you're gonna find a lot of motivated sellers in, because their back is frankly against the wall, okay? And that's what you're looking for. Not that you pray for that, but you know, when people's back is against the wall, it's the best time to prospect them. It's the best time for your solution that you bring to the table to stand out. Obviously, your solution is to buy the property and help them get rid of the property, so to say. It's really more about them than it's about you, right? So you want to help them get rid of that property. That's the angle you want to come in from, because the property has become a liability for them, right? A lot of people, sometimes they're underwater. They owe more than the value of the property. They owe more mortgage. The mortgage balance is a lot more than the value of the property. And when you have that kind of situation, typically from a conventional mindset, you know, conventional knowledge standpoint, you owe way too much than the property is worth. That means you can't sell. But then there's something called short sales in, you know, in the game of mortgages, and the bank just want to get rid of a mortgage of a bad performing asset. They call it a non-performing asset, right? So the banks are not in the business of managing properties. If somebody has stopped paying on the property, once it's up to 3 months, they've stopped paying on the property. In most cases, after a few months, the property kicks into what you call a pre-foreclosure. And these type of people, sometimes they are landlords that are tired, landlords that don't want to take care of the property, landlords that are just tired of having to babysit tenants or kicking tenants in and out of the property. It becomes a big headache, and they rather just let go of the property. That's where you want to step in and negotiate a deal that works for everybody. Win, win, win. You, the property owner, the bank, and all parties involved are happy to transition that property, to transfer that property, the deeds of that property from one person to the other, while nobody loses beyond what has already been lost. Because a lot of times people start making payment, they already mess up their credit, so it's not much they can do other than to just stop the whole process in its tracks, okay? So that's what pre-foreclosures are, and that's actually how I started back in 2005, and I did that heavily and got a lot of deals from those things, because once people have this bad experience, they have that bad experience, they don't want it. They just want to keep moving, right? They don't want to know that they can save it, or they don't want, you know, you're looking for people to want to sell anyway. We're not looking for people that want to save their property. If they want to save their property, you can provide some brokers information on how they can do that. But that's not how you make money. Maybe you can build some goodwill from that, right? The way you make money is somebody actually selling the property. Then you put the house on the contract, and then you get the property transferred to another person, or the property deed transferred to another person, and you can make money in between by facilitating the whole process. And that's what wholesaling pre-foreclosures is all about. So this person is starting that way. It's a great way to start, because when you're flipping or wholesaling pre-foreclosures, you don't need your own cash if you're wholesaling, okay? You don't need your own cash. You just need a network. You need to position some cash buyers in places and just facilitate the whole deal. From a private standpoint, of course, you're not acting as a realtor, but you're acquiring what you call an equitable interest in the property by putting it under contract. And then you could do whatever you want with that contract, as long as that means helping that person get rid of that property, right? So this person says, so after sending direct mail to pre-foreclosures for the past 3 months now, I've noticed something. I've gotten quite a few calls, but I have not set any appointment yet. Okay, so yeah, that's real. It happens like that. The way you get pre-foreclosures is that those lists are published. They're published in the county house, right? It's public records. Once somebody is 3 months, 4 or 5 months late, it's public records, and it gets published. And then you can take that list and the address, and you mail to that address, and that's how people get leads, right? And that process is still doable, but the response rate has dropped significantly lower from, and I know that hands-on experience because I left the business when the market crashed in 2008, and I came back about 8 years, like 2008, 2014. Okay, so I came back about 6 years later, and it's just a, is this 6 years? 8 years? Six, yeah, 14. Yeah, 6 years later. And the business is completely different because the response rate from direct mailing were ex a lot more lower for obvious reasons, which I didn't pay attention to. First of all, they are training everybody just like you to go try do wholesaling. So everybody's mailing these people, and it's just different. You know, most people hang out on their phone. They hang out on their phone now, you know, they hang out digitally, they ask questions from the phone, they ask questions from Siri for the next move of their biggest financial decisions, right? So if you're not well positioned in this marketplace, you're gonna lose a lot of money trying to send direct mail to pre-foreclosures. So it still works. I just think I know that the response rate is a lot lower, and there's you gotta do things a little bit differently, you know. And I wanna talk about all that in a second here, right? But let me continue the question. So I noticed something. I've gotten quite a few calls, but I have not set any appointment yet. At least you're getting calls, right? So if you're getting calls, that's a good thing. So there may be something you're saying on the phone that's wrong. You know, what I always like is that the key thing I tell people when you receive calls is make sure your position, your posture when you're receiving that call is positioned in a way where you can say, how may I help you? Okay? How may I help you? How may I help you? And you want to let them tell you their story. Just shut up. After you say that, this is Ola. How may I help you? Yeah, I'm calling because of this letter. Okay, tell me a little bit. Tell me more about your story. What's going on with the property? And you just want to shut up and let them tell you, give you all the ammunitions that you need to close the deal for an appointment. Okay. Now, one of the biggest mistakes you're going to make is trying to talk them into giving you an appointment or trying to interrupt them while they're still telling you the story. You want them to tell you a story. You want to say, tell me the story. What's going on with the property? And then, what well, the property, you send me a letter because it's in pre-foreclosures right now. All right, tell me more. You want them to talk. You want to have time for them. You want them to talk for 7, 8, 9 minutes. You probably don't even want to say much until 10 minutes mark. And you say, okay, sound like something I can help you with. When is a good time I can come through the property? What one thing you need to understand about human beings is that we like to talk about ourselves. Okay, we like to ha the idea of having someone to rant to, someone to talk to. You know, we like that. You know, so you want to pay attention to that when you're prospecting. Let people talk. For crying out loud, let people talk. Ask them quality questions like, what do you mean? Right? Tell me the story. Okay, tell me what's going on with that. What, how did that make you feel? Wow, that's crazy. Wow. So tell me, so you got into a situation with the property, and the property is now late 3 months. Is there anything else that's affected with that situation? Just please tell me the complete story so I can know how I can help you. You want them to tell you the whole thing. How's the family? Like things like that. You're trying to build rapport with these people, okay? But you want to feel on it. It's not an exact science. It's a heart and a science. You want to feel on it, feel on the conversation, and make them feel comfortable and let them tell you the whole story. Because by simply doing that, they close themselves on having an appointment with you. Okay, so that's one thing right off the bat I can tell you that you're probably doing wrong if you're getting calls but you're not closing. Securing an appointment, okay? So he goes, I tried following up, but I haven't been able to get any of them on the phone after the first few calls, which they initiated. Right. So here's the thing. Once somebody get off the phone with you and you don't close them on an appointment, chances are they're gone forever, okay? And there's a good solution for that, okay? And I'm going to share that with you as the three C's, which is probably the reason why you came here to this video right now. Three C's stands for create, capture, and convert, okay? And I'm teaching everybody now to practice it more than ever before, because if you remember what I said earlier, direct mail, the response rate is not as good as it used to be. Never mind what the gurus are telling you. Some of them will tell you 5, 7, 6%. It's a lie. None of them are counting, okay? Many of them, some of them have enough money to just keep mailing. Okay, if you close one deal, you can mail without looking at the numbers for the next 1 year and still get deals, right? And that's where you want to be, right? But if you're starting off brand new, these numbers are going to be off for you and you're going to be disappointed, and that's not what you want, right? So the key thing that I want to teach you here is the create, capture, and convert, so you can offset the marketing cost. Okay, the idea of create, capture, and convert is to offset your marketing cost. It costs money to send those mailings, and it adds up pretty nicely. Now, if people are contacting you and you can get them on the phone only once and you can't get them on the phone ever again, then that's really bad. You gotta create a follow-up system in place where you're capturing people's contact information. When I say contact information, not phone numbers, because like you said, they're not picking up the phone anymore, right? But you want to capture their digital contact information, and the best digital contact information you want to capture this time and age is email address, right? So how are you going to capture their email address? Well, I'm talking about capture, which is the second C. Now let's go back to the first C, and that's create. You need to create something tangible. It could be a PDF. Like when I say tangible, I mean digitally tangible. Okay, that means information. Okay, that means something that can actually help them. So if you're talking about avoid foreclosure, you want to give people information, okay, in a simple PDF on how to avoid foreclosure. If you're talking about I buy houses cash, you want to give people a full-blown PDF report, right, where they can download that in exchange for their email address. You send them to a website using the direct mail pieces that you're sending out to them. You send them to a website, you say, hey, go to this page and download this on how to avoid foreclosure, or download this on how to sell your house very fast within 9 days. So another good source of quality motivated sellers is expired listings. So people that listed their house for sale, it's lasted about 90, 100 days on the market, but nobody bought it. These are a good source of leads. And you want to give those people information how to sell your house fast in 9 days, and give them solid information. There's information on the internet about that. You can interview top realtors in the marketplace about that. And you can give them some valid information with stamped at the bottom of each one of those documents. You're creating information, you're creating value for people. You're actually showing them how they can fix their problem without trying to capture their house first. You're giving value first, and if you do that long enough, you know, the blessings will come back to you. You know, giving is a universally accepted principle of first step before you receive, right? So now you get to practice that. You give them the information, do some research, write a write-up. I mean, if you've went to college or stuff, you've written stuff before in the past, write it in your own language. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be Oxford, Harvard level conversation. No, it can be as simple as this conversation I'm having with you, and you give it away on a website, on the web page, where they can submit their email address first in order to download that information. And then now you have their digital contact information, okay? And now you can set up a series of follow-up emails, okay, that will continue to send them more information over time. That you can continue to use. When you send them more information that's valuable to them over time, guess what? You're creating value, and you're giving it away for them. And you're now building what I call relationship equity. You're building brand equity. And you're building closing equity. You don't have to do such a hard work on trying to close people on doing business with you, because they're not looking at you as the expert. Not because you call yourself an expert like a clown, but because you're truly an expert, because you're giving to them first before you're trying to take away from them. And you're giving authentically. You're helping them by actually helping them by giving them this information that they would otherwise have to go research all over the place. You do the research. You collect all this lead together. You have their contact information. You send them a mail at home. Put a little website at the bottom of the mailing and say, hey, if you want to learn, you can call me. If you want free consulting, sure. But if you want to learn, I have a free PDF for you ready at this website. All you have to do is go there, and enter your email address. Boom, you capture, you send it, you get a download of the PDF. So you create, you capture, and then conversion is automatic because, again, you're pre-framing the mind of those people that you're the best person for them to do business with because you've done the work, you've done the research, you've given them information. And not everybody that download will do business with you, but enough people will do enough business with you, and you will offset your marketing costs because now your email automatic follow-up from your autoresponders will continue to market to those people for free. Everybody else are busy sending that one letter mailing one time and that's it, right? They send that letter mailing one time, and if they call, you lose them, that's it. They don't pick up the phone anymore. They block your number because you're bothering them trying to put their house under contract. That's because you're leading with trying to take away from them as opposed to lead with give first. You need to be leading with value. You need to be leading with value. You go into such relationships to give. You will get, okay? But you go there to give, okay? You will get. They will give you their house. A good number of people are going to say, you know what? I think the options that I like is short sales. You look like the guy that can get that done for me, or you can facilitate to make that happen for me. You make money by simply having people deciding to do business with you that way, okay? So as let me see here. So I tried following up, but I haven't been able to get any of them on the phone after the first few calls which they initiated. Yeah, that's because you're trying to take away their house first, okay? And you're not showing up as a leader, with value, okay? That's just what that means. All right, but if you give value first, you're telling people to go download from your website, you're saying it with authority. Because why? Because this is information that's valuable, information that's going to cost them their whole house, okay? Information worth thousands of dollars, right? And you're giving it away for free in exchange for a mere email address. Number one, you're capturing email address so you can follow up digitally, right? Number two, they're looking at you as the expert. Does that make sense? So he says, do you have trick to this? And how can I get these people on the phone for a follow-up? So there's the first step, you know, the idea of how can I get them on the phone is clingy, is needy, right? And that's probably showing up in your posture when you try to call these people. I mean, you probably try to blow up their phone. They probably have seen a missed call of your same number over and over again. That's annoying, okay? You can imagine that. That's clingy, that's needy. And nobody likes that. Nobody likes to work with needy people, right? It's the same thing in relationships, right? If you're needy and you're coming up, you're gonna push that person away even further, right? But if you remain in your posture, you know that you come to the, at the back of your mind, you know that you come to the table with solid value. If you just know that you bring solid value to the table, then you show up like a boss. Then if somebody doesn't want what you have to offer in one offer, you move on to the next person. It's called leads. That's why you want to be capturing more leads, right? You send those mailings out. You offer your free PDF on the web page, and you say, hey, feel free to consult with me. You leave your number, and now they download your stuff. Now you have their email address, but now they're receiving email on a regular basis with your phone number, with your stamp of your name as the expert at the bottom of every email, and you're giving value. You've repurposed the content in your PDF into multiple different emails. For the next 60 days, they'll keep getting emails from you on how they can avoid foreclosure and how they can sell their property fast within 9 days, all those kind of things they're getting from you. Guess who they're gonna call? The next time they wanna call somebody to do business with when it comes to real estate, they're gonna call you. And even if they don't do business with you, they may end up referring somebody else to you to do business with you because you set up your business like a pro, like a professional. Does that make sense? So that's my way around it, okay? What I'm telling you right now is if you're spending money into the marketplace, into marketing, and there's no way for you to capture contact information in a way that's not annoying, in a way that's not needy and clingy, like trying to call them on the phone, in a way like if you do that, right, you're gonna chase them away, right? Because you're coming off needy, right? So if you set up your business in a way that you can continue to follow up without coming off needy, then you win the game of entrepreneurship in general, but especially real estate wholesaling, right? You wanna be the person creating, you wanna be creating content all the time, so you can give that away in form of PDF. You wanna capture the contact information in exchange for download, right? But on top of that, let's go back to create for a second. You could be in a position where you can create value like this, right? You can create value like this over and over in exchange, in exchange for people coming back to your website to learn about. You can create a YouTube channel on giving this kind of value away on how to avoid foreclosure and stuff like that. And that could be the same content you're emailing to them. But on top of that, it will be ranking in the search engines, okay? Now, wholesaling business, there are multiple sides to wholesaling business, right? There's the getting the motivated seller, right? But it's also building a cash buyer list, which I cover in details in other videos. You can learn that. You can just type in Ola Talks Abitogun, finding cash buyers, right? You'll find one of my videos on that topic, right? But it's the same concept. People who are going to buy from you would like to see you as the expert first, okay? Why don't you give them information that is valuable to them? What about a calculator on how to calculate cash flow on rental properties? What about how to flip homes for sale? What about how to buy your dream home and things like that without getting into trouble? Can you create videos and content like that and then capture people's contact information in exchange for a free consultation, right? Or a free PDF on pitfalls to avoid when you're buying your first home or you're buying your first rental properties. You can do some research and come up with this material, and you be the one creating this material, creating this value for the marketplace, because an average person will not do them. And that's why you win, because an average person, they're not going to commit to doing this stuff. And that's why you win all the time if you commit to doing it. And then converting, which is the last C, converting them to buy your end, being your end buyer, is effortless because they're preframed to do business with you. Their mind is preframed to do business with you. So is the other buying end of the game, which is acquiring motivated sellers. It's the same thing, right? Their mind is preferring to do business with you because you are the expert in the marketplace. Because when you teach, because you're teaching essentially when you're giving this value away, when you teach, you learn twice. And not only do you learn twice, you gain twice because you're the one that's visible. Everybody can see in the business, okay? Does that make sense? So if you want to learn how I do all of this and all this stuff, you want to come on inside. You see the link on the screen, olatux.com/mastermind. That's OLATUX. .com/mastermind. That's the link you want to go download all the downloadables from there. Take advantage of everything I have inside. You will also see my contact information on the inside. And in the meanwhile, this video, if you like this video, you want to keep getting more of it, click subscribe and the bell right next to it. Make sure you share this video and like this video. Give me a thumbs up, okay? If you have any questions, you have thoughts around this topic and you want to share it, I would love to hear your thoughts and your question. Drop them in the comment box below. Hopefully you've been enlightened and educated, and I will see you on the next one. Peace.